All right, I'd like to welcome Lydia Ko into the interview room. Lydia, congrats on another great finish today. Can you take us through your day and how you're able to score so well?
Well, today I didn't make any bogeys, and that was really helpful because, you know, sometimes a bogey in the middle of your round can, you know, make your confidence go a little down. So it was good, and I played pretty consistent, and I made all pars in the front nine, so, and it's not an easy nine, so I noticed even's not that bad, even though, you know, I would have wanted to shoot a couple under. Yeah, and my goal was 4 under today, and I shot 4 under in the back nine, which is good once again, and I did that yesterday as well, so I think I really like the back nine, and hopefully it likes me too.
You've had an incredible amateur year so far, becoming the U.S. amateur champion and playing in 10 professional golf events at 15 years old. People are starting to take notice of you. So tell us a little bit about yourself. Tell us, you know, how you're able to balance being a teen and a professional golfer, and do you feel like you're missing out on anything?
Yeah, I'm definitely missing out on a lot of, you know, teenager, you know, activities. No, I'd love to go out on a Saturday night with my friends and, you know, watch a movie, but that happens really like once a year or a couple times a year. And last year I had wrist surgery, and that's when I could do a little bit of teenager stuff. But yeah, it just doesn't happen that often. But now I'm realizing golf is like a full-time job, and I'm missing a lot of school. And at this age, you know, I should be going to school every day. And when I see my report, for the first term, I was there for, I think, 2 weeks. So my absent days are like 75 days or something. So, I mean, this is a full-time job, and I guess, like me, I don't have anything to lose, like, playing this tournament. I'm just, you know, here for experience. But, you know, the professionals, on the other hand, it's about how much money they're going to get by each placing, so... Yeah, I sometimes really miss going out with my friends, and that's why I actually like school, because I can, you know, see my best friend there, and even though it's school and you have to do work, I get to still see her. Yeah.
Having played 2 other LPGA events this year, are you starting to feel comfortable playing with the pros? And I'm sure you look up to a lot of them, so who's your favorite and why?
It's always nerve-wracking, you know, playing with the pros, and you're actually playing against the pros. And I'm really here for experience, and it's awesome to, you know, see what the pros can do. And the biggest thing I actually learned was at the Australian Open, which is also another LPGA event, where I played with Kari Webb, and there was a tree in front of us, and our balls were pretty much next to each other, and I had to lay up and then, you know, chip it next to the hole, but, you know, she hit it over the tree and next to the pin, and that kind of shows that she's got a lot of experience and she knows really what she's doing. And that was, I think, one of the biggest things I learned when I was playing with the pros. And yeah, it's always fun, and my favorite player is Michelle Wee and Lexi Thompson. I don't know why, but they both turned, well, I don't know why they both did turn professional at a young age. And I mean, I really look up to them, and I think they're awesome players, and coincidentally, they turned professional early. Yeah, and I want to give time for college and everything as well. And yeah, I think they're both amazing players, and hopefully they'll be able to, you know, have many more success in the following years. Yeah.
Questions for Lydia?
Lydia, how much confidence did the U.S. amateur win give you, and do you think you can win here? I mean, do you feel like your game is good enough that you can beat what is a very, very good field of pros here?
Yeah, it gave me a lot of confidence, and my putting is really not the strong point in my game, and from 2 weeks ago, I putted really good, and Kay Cockerell said, "You're a short game queen," and, you know, that gave me a lot of confidence. And I wasn't, you know, having a really good day with my long game, but my putting just saved me, and that's why I was able to win most of my matches. So, yeah, from there I kind of realized, you know, you don't need to have the best day in your long game to shoot low scores. It's, you know, mostly about putting, and that's why people say, you know, drives, it's all for show, and putting for money. Yeah, so yeah, it gave me a lot of confidence, and I mean, I played 3 events in the States, and I've gotten a medal for each one of them. So yeah, hopefully I'll be able to bring home the medal for this tournament.
How much attention are you getting back home in New Zealand? I know it's a rugby nation, but your exploits on the golf course, are you getting a lot of media attention back home?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, New Zealand isn't the biggest country ever. Yeah, and I'm getting a lot of support. And I mean, for the US Open, I was shooting 3 under till 15, and then I kind of made double bogey, then triple, so I lost 6 shots in the last 3 holes. So then I searched up my name, and then I saw these media, and it says, Lydia bails out of the last 3 holes. Lydia does something, and I was like, oh, I better not do that anymore. Yeah, I was like, oh, that was quite an impact. So I guess every shot counts, and I just got to play pretty consistent golf.
You talked about school, and obviously it's summer holidays here, but back home, school's in, right?
Yeah, I'm going back home in October the 3rd, so I've still got a while to go, and I left in June. So I'm not at home much, yeah, and our school is divided into 4 terms, and I'm going to miss the whole of term 3, and when I go back home in 2 weeks, I've got a Cambridge exam, so it's pretty tough, and it's hard to catch up, and I need to pass my exams to, you know, go to the next A-level, you know, academics. So it's hard to, you know, catch up, but I'll enjoy it when I go.
Do you follow the leaderboard way out there? Did you notice what Chella Choi was doing behind you?
No. The only time I really looked at the leaderboard was on 15. Yeah, suddenly, you know, people with the camera were coming, and I was like, are they actually going to take, you know, footage of me? And I was like, oh, man. And then I took a peek at the leaderboard, and my name was at the top. I was like, oh, my God. I am actually playing pretty good. And I kind of lost confidence after my front 9, but then my birdies on 12, 13, and 14 just made me go from this to way up there. So, yeah.
Lydia, you talked about the business of golf. Everyone's out there because it's a business. How important is it for you to also remember to have fun, you know, out there? I mean, obviously, you know, bogey-free golf is fun, but you know what I mean? Having the love of the game, which keeps you going through this.
Yeah, I enjoy it. And I mean, even if I have a bad day and I might feel really bad, I'm sure inside there's always things to learn. And from there, I can, you know, develop my game further. And yeah, I mean, I'll probably have more, as an amateur, we'll probably have more fun than the professionals, I guess. But I guess nearly 99.999% of the players out here are all enjoying their golf. It doesn't matter what they shoot. And I guess we all love the game. That's why we're playing, and everyone's working so hard and putting so much time into it.
With the success that you're having, and you talked about Michelle, you know, turning pro young. You talked about, you know, Lexi as well. You know, Michelle went to Stanford a little bit later on in her teenage years. Have you decided the path that you want to go when you decide to go pro? Do you want to play college golf, or do you want to follow Michelle's route? Have you figured that out yet?
I graduated in 2014, so I've still got a bit of time left to, you know, think over it. And yeah, it's like coincidentally they both turned professional early. I just like them separately, but I never knew that they turned pro early. And I mean, they wanted to do it because they really enjoyed the sport and they wanted to turn pro and everything. But yeah, I don't want to hurry anything. And like I said, I enjoy school a lot. And personally, I think you need to study and it will help with your game. Like, you know, if you do physics or math, that will help you read the lies or whatever. That's what my mom says. Yeah. Yeah. That's why next year I was like, oh, okay, I'm going to draw math. And she's like, no. I was like, oh, okay, maybe not. Yeah, so, yeah, it's nice. And I want to go to college, definitely, and somewhere in California. And I want to go to Stanford. And I like Michelle Wei because she go to Stanford. I don't want to go to Stanford because she went there. It's just I like Stanford, and then she actually went to Stanford. So kind of that direction. Yeah, and but then I'm noticing, and as the years go by, Stanford is such an academic school. And I actually talked to a girl, Sally Watson, at the US Amateur, how she felt, because she goes and studies at Stanford. And she said it's actually doable. So I'm actually rethinking again, because, you know, people are saying, oh, there's so much homework, there's so much this, and you can't have a lot of time, you know, practicing golf. And there are many great schools out there, and I think that's the great thing about the States, because such a big country, there's, you know, a college in pretty much every corner. Yeah, and in California, it doesn't snow, so I want to go there.
So Lydia, what was it like having someone from Vancouver as your caddy who knows the course and could give you some information that way?
It was good. Like 2 weeks ago at the US Amateur, my mom caddied, and that's kind of a different feeling because she's your mom and, you know, you have to listen to her. Yeah, and it was really comfortable having my mom there, but it's also really relieving and comfortable to have someone that knows the course off by heart, really. And he's been here for, I think, 10 years, so he knows where not to go and where to go. And there are quite a few tricky green lies, and that's, I kind of read it right to left, but, you know, Brian said, no, it's left to right, and he was right. So, yeah, he's definitely helpful. And, you know, I'm sometimes really unsure because, you know, I could be like in the middle, and I'm not sure, and you could push it or pull it a little bit. But with him there, I really have nothing to worry about. Yeah.
I see. So just on that note, you might have answered this, but do you find it a challenge to get a good caddy at the tournaments that you've been going to?
Yeah, fortunately, I don't know why. I think it could be luck. Everywhere I've been to, I've met really nice people, and all my caddies has been great, and I don't think I've had a caddy that was really horrible. So yeah, it's always good, and I think it's pretty much luck, and that's what my mom says. You're really lucky to meet so many great people along the way, and, you know, that's always helpful. And especially I've been here in Vancouver, but I haven't played golf over here, so it was also really nice to, you know, come over here, and everyone's friendly, and, you know, it felt like home. Yeah.
Lydia, the win you had the New South Wales Open, is that the tournament you won?
Yeah.
How much will that help you this weekend, knowing that you've already won a fairly significant professional event? I mean, will you draw upon that experience and some of your other experiences playing in pro events tomorrow?
Yeah, I think so. Actually, on the other note, at the U.S. Open, you know, the last round, everyone, you know, didn't have the greatest round, but, you know, I shot 300 to 15, and that showed that I was able to scramble along with the pros, and that kind of gave me a confidence, but not so confident for the next three holes. And for the New South Wales Open, it was a European tour event, so, you know, and it will help me out there, and it will give me a confidence saying that I could beat the pros, and you never know who's going to win. And, you know, we've still got two rounds to go, and there's still half the field needing to play. And yeah, it's going to be really helpful. And I don't know what position I'll be after everyone's finished, but Yeah, it will definitely give me a little boost.
I ran into a couple from New Zealand who I guess know you and who've extended their holiday so they could watch you play. You've got some support out there, right? People
yeah,
watching you play.
Joe and Brent, we actually have known them for a while, and Joe's actually originally from Canada, so they always have this trip in the middle of the year to come over and to also see their girls. And yeah, they said, I said, I'm playing the Canadian Open, and then they decided to, you know, extend their holiday. And it's always good to have people back home supporting, but also people from your country at the place to support you. And there's a lot of supporters other than them as well, so it was good to see them. And you know, it's always good to see the New Zealand flag going up.
What would you say was your toughest hole today?
I think the toughest hole normally is 15, but I made par both days. So, I mean, today I didn't feel like one was really tough, but I think 7, if anything, it's a par 3. In the practice rounds, I didn't really have any stress, and I hit it on the green, and you know, I was putting for birdie. But yesterday I was putting for bogey, and I was putting, well, I had like a 6-foot putt for par. So somehow it was a tough hole, and I don't know why. Yeah, I guess it's like tournament pressure and, you know, things you don't really see, you kind of see. So, yeah.
You mentioned, you know, some of the women out there that you look up to turning pro at a younger age. Obviously, you know, as you go on here, those questions are going to increase. Do you seek their advice at all? Have you had a chance to ask them about the positives and the negatives of the path they chose in terms of spotlight and all the different things that come with it?
No, I'm too scared to talk to them. Yeah, I mean, I look up to them so much, and I respect them so much. And yeah, I mean, hopefully if I have time and if they have time, I'll be able to ask them, you know, those kind of questions. And there are a few players out there that actually did turn professional at a young age. And but to me, like back in New Zealand, lots of the players that I used to play with, and they, you know, went to college right after high school. So that kind of got me into saying, oh, I want to go to college as well. And that's been my goal, one of my goals, since ages ago. So I don't think that would change. And, you know, as I won the US Amateur, there's been rumors that I'm going to turn pro really, you know, in like a year or something. But I'm going to turn pro in a couple of years, not a year.
I think you mentioned October 3rd going back. Just what are your plans after this? Like, what do you have lined up?
I've got the British Open, and then I've got the World Amateur Team Championships. So I've only got 2 tournaments left, but I've got kind of a break in between. So I'm going early to both events and practicing. Yeah, but after this week, actually, I'm going to Korea for a week. So, and I haven't been there since I left Korea. So it's been like 9-10 years, and it's basically going to be like a new country because I don't really have good memory and I can't remember the things from 2 years ago, so no way am I going to remember something from 9 years ago. Yeah.
Are your parents traveling with you, both of them, who's traveling with you, and what are those arrangements like just throughout this, since June through October?
My mom's been traveling with me from the start, and she most of the time travels me anywhere I go unless I go with the New Zealand golf team. My dad never ever travels with me. It's not a bad thing, it's just he's always at home, and yeah, he never really travels. And if I'm in New Zealand, my mom most of the time caddies for me, so my dad really doesn't have a reason to travel. And I've also got my sister, so he looks after her and she looks after him. Yeah.
So what grade are you in?
I'm in grade 11.
Grade 11?
But New Zealand go to grade 13.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you Like, do you do any schoolwork when you're on the road, like for extended stretches, like you are now? Or do you, are you doing any schoolwork, or do you just catch up when you get home?
I printed a couple of papers and I bought a few books, but to be honest, I haven't done much. Yeah, and especially like 2 weeks ago, I'm playing 34 holes, 35 holes, and full 18 holes, and it's pretty stressful by that. And me doing extra work will probably kill me.
I just wonder about the whole Stanford thing. I mean, it seems like you're not going to high school much. I mean,
yeah.
Are you going to be able to get into a place like Stanford?
I mean, I'm going to work hard, and I've still got 2 years, and the actual, scoring counts from this year. So, and I got 99% in math in my last exam, so that's not too bad. I'm not going to talk about the other few.
Any more questions for Lydia? Thank you so much for coming in, and good luck for the rest of the week.